Hello, welcome to Macworld, and welcome to our top 10 countdown of the best iOS games ever. The best games we've played on our iPads and our iPhones. We'll get straight in there at number 10. It's a new entry. It's You Must Build a Boat. This is the sequel, technically, I think. Not the same name, but the same gameplay as a game called 10 Million. And it's a little bit like Candy Crush, only a lot better. It's a match three game, which means you're moving these little tiles around, you're trying to match three things that are the same, and then they disappear. You've seen this sort of thing before, but if you look at the top of the screen, there's a little guy running along there, and he's fighting monsters, he's finding treasure chests. It's kind of like a little bit of an RPG at the same time. And this throws a little bit of extra complication into the formula, because you need to find specific things to match together to solve the specific problems that he's having. So you need to find swords and magic sticks to fight against the monsters, and you need to find keys to open the chests, and there'll also be specific things you're trying to get for the specific quest you're on each time. So you might need to kill a specific type of monster. On to number 9, it's Limbo, which we've had in the past. I can't imagine us ever taking Limbo out of our top 10. It's a wonderful game. It's a very gloomy game, as you can see here. It's very influenced by expressionist cinema. It's a very cinematic game. It's also very pessimistic and dark, as you can see there. If you're an arachnophobe, you probably want to look away now, because it has the scariest spider in, I think, the history of computer games. There he is, creeping in now. It's a puzzle game and a platform game, so you're going from left to right in that usual hallowed tradition from games like Mario, but you're trying to avoid the various bloodthirsty perils that are around you, solve little puzzles by moving things around. You'll also die a lot, as we will show now. Gruesome stuff, really nasty, but a lot of fun at the same time, disturbingly, and just a wonderful, beautiful game. Number 9 is Limbo. Number 8 is Super Hexagon, and this is a very simple game, but a game that does one thing incredibly well. It's a very fast, sort of a competitive puzzle game, maybe an arcade game is the way to describe it. You're controlling this little triangle at the centre of the board. You can rotate him by pressing either left or right to turn either clockwise or anti-clockwise, and you're trying to get through all these little gaps between the shapes that are moving in at an increasingly dangerous speed. And it gets faster and faster and more complicated. You only have to survive 60 seconds to pass a level, but you'll find that that's really hard. And the music gets the adrenaline pounding. It's a very exciting game, considering that you're just dealing with some shapes. Number 7 is another new entry, our second new entry. It's actually quite an old game. It's Carcassonne. It's one of the best and most beloved board games around at the moment. We think it's the best iPad board game there is, and it's actually displaced Puerto Rico, which was in last time. We think this is more accessible, and having played a lot recently, it really is the best game around for iOS board gamers. It's a tile laying game. You're putting down tiles on each turn, you have to make them match the other tiles around them, and have to be very tactical about where they go, because you get points by putting your little men on the tiles, and then you're trying to horn in on other people's large cities and large roads and get some of their share of the points, while at the same time trying to stop them from doing that to you. There are good expansions. Here's the Traders and Builders expansion, which makes it even more complicated, even more tactical, but it's just a fantastic game. It looks good, it sounds good, and it's very tactically deep, considering how simple and accessible it is. Number 6, another new entry. This is Dream Quest. Try not to be put off by what you're seeing in front of you, because graphically this is a very, very weak game. Sort of consciously so, they decided not to put any resources at all into working on the graphics. So you've got little stick men, you've got very gaudy cartoon graphics that don't look nice at all. There is always talk with this game that they're going to overhaul the graphics. Somebody's going to do it for them for cheap, because they love the game so much. I'm almost reluctant for them to do that, because what this game is about is gameplay above everything else, and it's really, really strong gameplay. It's sort of at the cutting edge of the trends at the moment. It's a card playing game, a deck builder you'd call it, but it's at the same time it's a roguelike RPG, a role-playing game. So your little dude is going around the map, your little badly drawn dude is going around the map. compiling a deck of cards, and there are things like attack cards and spell cards, action cards and things like this. And then when you fight somebody, you play with your deck. And when you beat them, you get some more cards, and it's all about building up a good deck. It's a fantastic game. Number five is Threes, another sort of tile-based game, a tile pusher, you might call it. It's a simple little puzzle game, been ripped off royally across the App Store to a shocking extent. You heard a game called 2048, 1024 is another one. These are all just ripped off from this game. And if you buy any of those or get them for free, because they're nearly always free, then you are part of the problem and I have no sympathy for you. This is a really nice game, really original, aside from everything else. It's been beautifully designed. It's actually a lot better than any of the clones and rip-off artists anyway, even if it wasn't the original. Lovely game, the sort of thing that we want to encourage more of on the App Store, so please buy this. Don't get any of the imitations. Four. Another new entry, Grimrock, Legend of Grimrock. This has actually displaced Baldur's Gate. This is our new favourite RPG on the iPad. It's quite retro in gameplay and style. It's very similar to games like Eye of the Beholder, you might remember from back in the 90s, and some other games earlier even than that. It's also got quite nice modern smoothly animated graphics. It looks very nice, so it's sort of taking the classic gameplay and applying modern stylings to it. As I said, it's an RPG, it's a dungeon crawler, really nice sort of simple storyline that you're sort of dumped into the top of this dungeon because you've committed a load of crimes and you have to fight your way all the way down to the bottom of the dungeon to get out. You have four characters, they could be wizards and things like that, and then you have to upgrade them, go up level, get them new equipment. It's really deep, but there's so much content in here, so much to learn about and do, and it's just terrific fun. Number three is Monument Valley, a classic. This was in last time. It's been knocked down a place, you might have noticed. I'll have to see what comes into number two. But Monument Valley, you can't keep it down for long. It's a beautiful game. It sounds beautiful as well. It's all about optical illusions, sort of M.C. Escher landscapes and structures. And the puzzle on each level is to manipulate the impossible architectures around you, because anything that looks possible is then possible. If you can make something, if you can make two walkways connect with each other, even though they shouldn't, but if you can make it look like they connect, then they do connect and you can walk across. So it's all about manipulating perspective and things like that. This is a stunning game, and we want developers to be attracted to the App Store and make things like this, because it's a crying shame when they get forced away. Number two, our highest new entry. This is what knocked out Monument Valley. This is a wonderful game. Current obsession of this particular gamer. It's a survival game, brutal survival game. You get cast out in the wilderness and you have to survive. And as the name suggests, the primary problem is food. So you have to try and grow farms and rear livestock and kill animals and eat their meat and that sort of thing. Pick up carrots, grub around in the dirt. Lots of animals will attack you. When it gets dark, you have to make sure there's a fire or you'll get murdered cruelly. So you need to make sure you've got enough wood. There's always things going on. There's always things to worry about. Your sanity, for example. You actually have a sanity meter, entertainingly or disturbingly, how you look at it. I play this all the time to the detriment of personal relationships. But if you look at this, look how many ways there are for you to die. Cruel, horrible ways to die, because it's like a roguelike in that it's permanent. When you die, you have to start again. Horrible. Talking of permanent death, this is number one. It's FTL. Of course it's FTL. FTL was number one last time. I can only imagine it'll be number one until the end of time, because this is a fantastic, fantastic game. FTL is what we call a strategy roguelike, sort of combination of two genres. It's a strategy game because you're controlling a spaceship and you're controlling all the crew members on the ship and telling them what to do. It's a roguelike because, like that particularly cruel genre of role-playing game, each level you go through is randomly generated, so it's different each time, And secondly, death is permanent. It's what we call permadeath. And this lends a fantastic sense of tension to the battles you'll have with other ships. It means everything counts, everything matters. There's a lot of depth to the game as well. It might not look particularly deep when you look at it like this, but there are lots of different ways you can play the game, lots of different ways you can upgrade your ship. You can focus on pure artillery bombardment, you can go for a boarding strategy, you can get a teleportation device and send your men onto the enemy ship. A lot of this is adapted on the fly as well, because you have to find equipment as you go, you have to buy what's available, and so you have to work something out on the fly, you have to adapt, be very flexible. You'll play it lots of times, and each time will be different, not just because of the randomly generated levels, but because you'll try different strategies, and there's just so much to learn about in this game. It is wonderful. And that is the end of our top 10. FTL comes top again. Please do play that game, because it is amazing. Tune in again next time, because we will update this again probably towards the end of 2015. See which games stay and which get kicked out, and of course keep coming back to macworld.co.uk for all of your iOS gaming needs.